Hello, this is Deanne from SmallButKindaMighty, and this video is a brief demonstration of the Bitsboard app, together with a few thoughts on why I think it's a terrific app for homeschoolers, parents, and educators, especially in these times of remote learning. By the end of this video, you will know how to use the Bitsboard app and how I'm using it with my autistic teens who are currently attending high school under a hybrid system. They are currently doing in-person learning for 2 to 3 mornings a week, and the remainder of their school time is spent on remote learning from home. Owen recently got an assignment for his food and nutrition class on the new Canada food guide, and it dawned on me, Bitsboard is perfect for this. So what is Bitsboard? Well, in the App Store, it's called Bitsboard Flashcards and Games, but don't immediately dismiss it as just a flashcard app for preschoolers. In the description box below, I've linked to all 3 versions of the app that are currently in the App Store. There's a version that's free, so parents and educators can give the app a try at no cost. You can upgrade within the app and try all the pro features for a free 7-day trial period, and then pay for continued access to the pro features via subscription fee. Or, if you prefer, you can simply pay upfront and purchase the pro version of the app. The third version of the app is for students and gives them access to all the features of the pro app, other than the ability to create and share classes and boards. I'm going to walk you through how to use the app and at the same time show you the features that I think make it a terrific, accessible distance learning tool for both teachers and parents. First, you want to set yourself up as a super user, and then the children who are going to be using the app should each have a user profile. Either tap on the plus sign at the bottom right of the screen to switch user, or tap on your user profile at the top of the screen and switch user. When you get to the user screen, tap the plus sign at the bottom right and add yourself as a super user first. Each child will then have their own user profile, which you will link to your super user account. If you want to create some classes from scratch, then in your super user profile, you set up your boards, bits, and classes. The first step is to create a board, then add the bits you want to use in that board. Secondly, you'll add the board to the class you want it in. Let me illustrate with an example. One of the classes that Owen is taking is food and nutrition. One of his assignments from that class is on Canada's new food guide. His teacher has asked him to identify as many foods from the Canada's new food guide plate as he can, and then to categorize those foods into fruits and vegetables, whole grains, and proteins. So, in Bitsboard terminology, I created a Canada's New Food Guide board. And then for each of the foods pictured on the Canada New Food Guide plate, I created a bit or a flashcard and added it to the Canada's New Food Guide board. Later on in the video, when I demonstrate the kinds of games that Owen can play with this app, it will become apparent how exactly this helps him complete his assignment. Before showing you how to add a bit or a flashcard to a board, I want to just quickly mention that one of the advantages of the Pro app is that you have access to the Bitsboard catalog. This catalog means that you don't have to create all of your bits, boards, and classes from scratch. In fact, you can download boards and even entire classes from the catalog. As you can see, there are classes and boards that are set up for kids of all ages and abilities on subjects as diverse as math, English, spelling, reading, comprehension, learning a new language, and life skills like telling time. If you want to create your own boards, bits, and classes, then the first step is to create your boards. In this example, I'm going to create a class for Owen on his people. And in that class, I'm going to create boards for my family, my teachers and support staff, and my classmates. We'll start by creating the My Family board. Tap on your super user profile at the top of the screen and choose User Settings. In the board section, either tap on the plus sign at the top right or tap on the Add Board icon. Once you've created the boards you want, then go to the Classes section, create a class for the boards, and then add the boards you want in that class. At this point, you can choose which students or kids you want to have access to this class. To add a bit or flashcard to a board, then go to the board, in this case, My Family, and tap on the plus icon. If you want to add a specific image, then tap on Add Media and add a photo from your camera roll or a Google search, Dropbox, or you can even add a video from YouTube. Once you've added the media you want to use, then complete the label at the top and add a description in the description box. If you don't have specific images of your own that you want to use, then Bitsboard Pro offers images that you can use from their catalogue. Let me illustrate by adding a bit to the Canada's new food guide board. I'm going to type in banana and then press done.
Banana.
As you can see, I was offered a selection of images, and the image of the banana I chose came with a pre-recorded voice label. After typing in the description, I tapped on Add Related Items and selected the other fruits that are on the board. It'll become apparent when I demonstrate a couple of the games why it's important to ensure that each bit or flashcard has a voice label, a description, and that you indicate what are the related items on that board. Going back to Owen's Canada's new food guide assignment, his teacher wanted him to take a look at the Canada's new food guide plate and name all the foods that he could see. Now, Owen can't talk, he can't write very well with a pen, and getting him to use his talker or type the answer to the question, okay, what's this food? What's this food? Would be pretty boring for all parties concerned. Instead, we can play the Explore and Photo Touch games in the Canada's new food guide board. And if I want to make sure that he doesn't get distracted and start playing other games, then I can go into his user profile and restrict the games for that board to just Explore and Photo Touch. The Explore game is a terrific way to introduce new items, new words, new concepts. Tap on Explore and you'll see all the bits or flashcards for the Canada's new food guide board.
Broccoli.
Tap on a picture and you'll hear the voice label for that bit or flashcard, and you can also read the description. Now, Owen knows the names of most foods, but there are a couple of reasons why I find Explore still useful. One of them is as a conversational prompt for whichever adult is with him to converse with him using his AAC. When adults use Owen's AAC with him, they are modeling for him how to put words together in sentences. So, for example, comments.
Broccoli is a vegetable. Broccoli is a vegetable.
Or modeling how to ask and answer questions.
I love apple. Apples. Do you like apple? Apples. I love apples. Do you like apples?
The second reason I like the Explore game is because it gives Owen a chance to learn about foods that he hasn't been introduced to yet, like tofu. The Photo Touch game is a great way for me to share with Owen's teacher what he knows and to find out where the gaps in his knowledge are. Let me show you a round of the game.
Whole wheat pasta.
Broccoli. Butternut squash. Butternut squash.
Soybeans. Soybeans.
Cheese. Strawberry. Blueberries. Potato.
Brown rice. Brown rice. Brown rice.
Tomato.
Bitsboard produces a PDF of the scorecard, which I can email to myself or email to Owen's teacher or grandparents if I want to brag. And the app will also track Owen's progress over time. One of Owen's favorite games is Word Builder, and I want to quickly show you that because it's a good example of how you can modify the settings for the individual games in order to customize them to the abilities for each individual user. As you can see, the way the game is currently set up, you hear an audio hint, so the person says the word or phrase, walnuts, brown rice. And you also have visual hints. So you drag and drop the words or letters into the boxes at the bottom of the image.
Whole wheat pasta.
Peanuts.
If you want to make the game a little more challenging, then you can tap on the cog at the top right of the screen and go into the game's individual settings, where you can do things like turn off the audio hints, turn off the visual hints, customize the number of cards that you see for each round, customize the number of rounds that you need to play, and so on. Remember when we were creating our bits, I said that it was important to indicate whether items were related, and that was so that we could categorize all of our bits using the Sort It game. Let me play a game of Sort It and show you how that works.
Which items go together?
Green pepper.
Steak.
Red cabbage.
Strawberry. Spinach. Tomato. Cheese. Carrot. Yogurt. Peanuts.
Hopefully that's given you a flavor of the app and an idea of some of the possibilities. Here are my top five reasons why I think it's a great tool for remote learning for all ages and abilities. First, it's accessible. Kids don't have to speak or write in order to play the games. Second, it's easy to modify the boards and individual games to meet each student's strengths and needs. Thirdly, kids or students can play games, thereby working on assignments independently. Fourthly, access to the Pro Catalogue ensures that parents and teachers can potentially avoid reinventing the wheel. And it's easy to share boards, scorecards, and performance over time information between parents and teachers. If you haven't come across me before, I have been making videos about play-based learning and crochet on my other YouTube channel. I've decided to focus that other channel entirely on crochet. This channel will be focused exclusively on play-based inclusive learning. If that topic interests you, then you may want to check out these videos from my other channel. If you find this content helpful, then please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. Thanks so much for watching, and I will speak with you soon.